Reason I ain't playing my guitar, I strained my hand, and then of all things, I cut the end of my finger off here one day. And I'm afraid to play it right now, because if I slide down on the string, it'll have to go to bleeding in church, you know.
Amen.
I don't know why. I had clippers, and I clipped that thing good, you know, and I noticed it's sort of tough. And I thought, man, that skin's tough there. And I pushed down real hard, and I didn't pay no attention. I looked, and it was blood everywhere. I cut the end of my finger. Well, I don't think it cut the bone, but it cut the end of my finger. And then the other day, I strained my elbow. So I ain't had no stroke. I'm just trying to keep from moving it. And I don't want to make no big steps. If I had to catch with that, down I'd go. Amen. If the Lord didn't support us, I'd be right. But this is about Mama. I love to sing songs about Mama. My mama was something else. She was a little bitty lady. I seen her one time down in Coleman, Alabama. Big old policeman reached and got Daddy. We used to have street meetings all the time. And a big old policeman reached to get Daddy and him preaching. Mama jumped between them and went to speaking in tongues. And he wasn't like Matt Dillon. He didn't have no piece of leather, you know, attached to the bottom of his holster to his leg. And him and her down the street they went. He'd like to scare the police. She liked to call him. That old big 45 was just a puppy. He was going to be brave when Mama down there like scared to death. We was in church one night and somebody said, Sister Lawrence, the old mule right there fell between the pulling, you know, thing on the wagon. And that's the only way them people got to go. House is packed down and boys sitting up in the rafters down in Road Oak, Alabama. And Mama grabbed her bottle of oil and went out there and known that old mule had stood up on his feet. I like that. I believe that. I run over a tent stob one time. We used to have tents, you know, and when you drove them old stobs in, that steel would turn over. And I run into a tent stob and like tore my leg off. They didn't have antibiotics back then. Doctor said, I don't know what we do with the little boy's leg. I ain't no telling how many stitches they put in this leg over here. I was running outside and playing, you know, I'd run over one of them things, just tore my leg up. Got in at the house, got to where you couldn't, Mom and Daddy had to hold their nose to come in the room where I was at. My leg got so bad. Doctor couldn't do nothing about it. The old saints of God, like this little church right here, gathered together. And here they come, the house is full. And they prayed the prayer of faith. And I've had a little trouble out of this other one.
Glory to God.
But not the one in God, are you?
Amen.
My little sister. My little sister was 5 years old. She was blind as a bat. I know about this because I let her around. We played in the yard. Anywhere else. Old brother L.T. Rouse down in Clinton, Alabama, he prayed a prayer of faith. And the next morning she could say as good as I could. And she lived to be 70 years old, a little over 70 years old, and never had no trouble with her eyes. Glory to God. They said there's a lady got up at church a while back and said, y'all pray for me. He said, I got to go back to the doctor. He said, I think he sewed some scissors up in me. God don't do that. Praise the Lord. When he does it right. Amen. But I like to sing about Mom and Daddy and talk about Daddy and all of them. Because, see, back then, see, I was raised to love the Lord. You let me know if I live right and act right and do right, I'd go to heaven. If I didn't, I'd go to hell.
Yeah, that's right.
Praise the Lord. Man. We used to have church. I was about 5 years old, 6 years old. And they wouldn't let preach kids chew chewing gum. I might have told y'all about it, I don't know. But they wouldn't let us chew chewing gum like the preacher's kid, and the preacher wasn't supposed to wear a tie. And if they wore a red one, man, that was worse than this ring I got on here.
Come on, bro.
Mama, she'd get heavy, slide me up with my, I'd act like I, you know, I hadn't heard, just got tired of church and I'd go to nod. She thought I was sleeping, she'd slide me up behind her heels under the seat there. And then I'd see when they got the shot pad to foot, I went to work. I had a pair of little overalls, and I'd reach up on that bench and go to pulling that chewing gum off. That bench was just lined with chewing gum. I'd put that stuff in my overalls, and if I had some way to package it and ship it, I'd have been a millionaire now. But I'm going to tell you one thing. I seen to it a lot of creep preacher's kids had chewing gum. But anyway, y'all listen to this song. Well, her favorite spot was sitting round the window, rocking in an old rocking chair with her apron and her dress of calico, listening to the raindrops, watching the falling snow. And today I went again to the home place down the lane where I played when just a lad. All the good times possess my memory. What an empty feeling, no one will come me. Heaven will ever welcome a sweeter mom. So, well, I walk up the steps, all worn and weathered, and the porch was green with moss and torn down. Then I saw it, that wreath on Mama's door. Just one day before.
Heaven will ever welcome a sweeter mama. Earth will never lose a greater soul. If all
Jesus. Give our little band a hand. Praise the Lord. we got a fellow that when we go somewhere, if anything happens to our car or anything, he'll come get us off the road, and he take care of it, fix it, and we ready to go again. And he lives here in Federal. And I told him, I said, everywhere we go, we tell people about you. But I said, we don't show your picture. I said, he said, how come you don't show my picture? I said, well, you know, we don't want to ruin our reputation, so.
Praise the Lord, amen. Give the Lord a big hand clap. Amen. Y'all want to sing a few songs?
Yeah, Lord.
Come on up. Amen. Got a big echo on this thing for some reason. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. And you come to worship the Lord tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. I may enjoy the life, family. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Let's do a mic check real quick. Testing. Shirley?
Testing.
All right. That better?
Praise the Lord. All
right.
Vaughn? Praise the Lord.
Jay? Sue?
Praise the Lord.
Do it again, Sue.
Praise the Lord.
Read it.
Praise the Lord.
No. Do it
again,
read it.
Praise the Lord.
Yours
old? Yeah, it's old. It's just not loud.
Try it again.
Praise the Lord.
Something's going on there. All right. Now try it.
Glory to God.
It's yours, Sandra.
No, it's Rita's.
Is the cord maybe bad?
Try it again, Rita.
Praise the Lord.
Try it again.
Praise the Lord.
Is that better?
Yes.
Sandra?
Praise the Lord.
Eric?
Praise the Lord.
Do yours again, Eric.
Praise the Lord.
Somebody's still got some feet.
Testing.
All right. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I ain't doing that now. Mike, give me the batteries. What's that? What?
I think he was talking about that.
What did he say?
I don't know, something about messing something up.
That better? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
We need our spirit-filled preachers to teach us right from wrong. Who pray all night long.
Thank you, Jesus. It's going to be worth it after all.
Yes, ma'am.
I was trying to get away from that.
All we have to do is look in our Bible and find out that He's on His way. I believe that with all my heart. Praise the Lord. Do you love the Lord tonight?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Let's give Him a shout of praise. He's good tonight. I tell you, He's in this house. I've felt Him since I've been here. Have you not felt God? Come on. Give Him a big old hand clap tonight. He's worthy to be praised.
Praise the Lord. We're going to turn up the fire.
Hallelujah. Amen. I just got to share this.
Thank you, Jesus.
Friday.
Yes, God.
I was headed to Home Depot. And Alice worked together, bowling. We pulled in, he was driving my truck, and I was driving. I always let him drive. You don't ride with me, amen? I let them all drive, amen? I'd rather not drive, amen? But, I only drive if I have to, amen? But we was pulling in the Home Depot, and he just out of the blue just asked me, he said, "Brother, what all y'all like on the church?" I said, "Well, praise the Lord, all I like is putting a monitor cord from the sound booth to the monitor, from one monitor to the other monitor." I said, "That's all I like other than the carpet." About that time, the Spirit of the Holy Ghost hit me. I started weeping and crying, amen. Tears started running down my cheeks. I couldn't help it, amen.
Yeah.
I didn't want to help it either, Brother Lodge. Amen. I tell you, I looked over at Brother Alice and I said, "Alice," I said, "the Holy Ghost all over me." He said, "That's all right, brother. Just let him pour it out on you." Amen. He started crying too. Amen. We was just sitting there in the truck boo hooing. Amen. Having us a good old Holy Ghost time. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
I got straightened up and got my composure back. Amen. Thought I had it all together, Brother. Brother Lloyd, and I walked off in Home Depot. I got about 2 aisles down. I got to thinking about how I had been working and how I was just right there at the end, amen. And all of a sudden, it hit me again. I started crying right in Home Depot, amen. I know people thought something was wrong with me, but it was just the Holy Ghost, amen. I was having a good old time, amen. I can tell you, amen. God is a good God, amen, and He wants to bless you, amen. We need not to be ashamed of Him, amen, but we need to let people know, amen, that God's still real, amen, the Holy Ghost is real, amen, and there's a fire, amen, under your belt, amen. If you got the Holy Ghost, He wants to be let out, amen. He don't want you to hold Him back, amen. Don't be ashamed to cry, amen, or lift your hands and magnify Him and lift Him up, praise Him, no matter where you're at, amen. I remember one time I was ministering to a young man, and I was at a storefront there in Huntsville, and he had called me up. He was having a hard time, amen, and I began to minister to him right there in the store, and I stepped out on the front porch, amen. Next thing you know, I was out front, man. I was just pacing back and forth, just preaching away on the phone. And a man come in, he stopped and stopped at the door, amen, and he looked at me, and I just kept on preaching, amen. I'm telling you, amen, God knows what He's doing, amen. And that man stood there and listened to everything I had to say. He didn't in the store, amen. He wanted to hear what God had to say, amen. And I was just obeying the Lord, amen. But I like what Brother Lodge said when he said, you know, when Jesus says, just do it, amen. Just do it, amen. That's all we got to do. We just got to do what He wants us to do, amen. And if we'll just be obedient to Him, He'll pour His blessings out upon us, amen. He'll touch those that which are lost, amen. He'll save them, amen. He knows what it's going to take to get them in, amen. All He wants to do is to use you. You're an instrument that God wants to fine-tune tonight, amen, and get zoned in, amen. We all need to come together, get in one mind and one accord. We didn't have a great big turnout, amen, but I'll tell you what, we got the Spirit of God here, amen, and that's all that matters, amen. We just need to lift Him up and magnify Him. He knew who was going to be here and who wasn't, amen. I come to worship Him tonight, amen. He's been good to me, amen. I'll tell you, amen. I love Him with all my heart, amen. I'm not ashamed of Him, amen. I called the landlord a while ago. I said, "Hey," I said, "I just want to let you know we're having a singing tonight, and y'all are welcome. Just come on. We done started, but you just come on in." He said, "Well, we're coming back from a car show." He said, "If we get there and y'all still going, we might just pop on in." I said, "Well, you just come on in, amen." But they had been praying, Brother Lodge, that somebody would take this
church, somebody that loved the Lord and that would serve God, somebody that wasn't ashamed of God, amen, somebody that would preach the truth. And I want to see them come in, amen. I want to touch them, amen, through the Spirit of God. I want God to use us, amen, to get them back in church, amen. I'm telling you, amen, there's a lot of people, like Brother Lodge said, that's out of church that used to be in church, amen, but they need to get back in because the day is drawing nigh, amen. Jesus is soon coming back, amen, and it's our job to reach out to them, amen. It's our job to be a witness, amen, and stand up for God, amen, and let God use us, amen. I'm telling you, amen, all God wants us to do is serve Him, Brother Johnny. That's all He wants. We'll just serve Him and worship Him. Amen. If you love the Lord tonight, worship shouldn't be hard for you. Amen. It should come easy. Amen. God has been good to me. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Turn up the fire, the devil said. Seven times a call to the Hebrew boys was dead. I surely pray and get away.
Yeah. Come on.